Oh man. Oh man, it's cold. So courage was never my strong suit. In fact, the very first talk I ever gave was on courage. But ironically, I was scared out of my mind. Within a 30-minute time slot, I gave it in 10 minutes. In panic, I told knock-knock jokes to one person, and in more panic, I told the same knock-knock joke, and I had to get asked to leave the stage. I was completely humiliated, and ironically, I give talks for a living now. Now flash forward a couple of years and I'm giving my very first talk with the Culture Project, and it's completely opposite. I'm all in, I'm ready, I'm confident, and a friend of mine pulls me aside and says, "Randall, that was the real you, wasn't it? Like, that was the you that you've been hiding away. That was the you that you shut away in fear for anyone else to see." And I realized that when I live in fear, when I don't live in courage, then my authentic self doesn't get to show. And as a result, I don't get to be the gift that I was created to be. I took the day to come to the St. John Paul II National Shrine in Washington, D.C. John Paul II is my biggest hero. And when I'm paralyzed, when I don't have any answers, he's the one I think of. He's the one I look to. Not only did he take the world by storm, but he also took the hearts of young people by storm as well. This man lived a heroic life. I mean, he loved and forgave his assassin. He wrote the Theology of the Body, and when he visited Poland under communist regime, they would not stop applauding him for 14 minutes straight. That is just a testament of how great this man was. But as many of us know, his greatness wasn't carved out of the amazing things he's done. His greatness and courage were carved out of the immense tragedy that he suffered. By 20 years old, he lost his entire family, and he grew up under the Nazi regime in Poland, and right after, the communists took over his country. So it was very easy for him to see the world as this dark and gloomy place, this place of despair, this place that is absent of love. But as Chris Stefanik has said in one of his videos, he wasn't renowned for his pessimism and gloomy attitude, but he was renowned for his courage and optimism. And it's this attitude that continues to pull me forward when I run out of answers, where I don't have anything else to say, when I don't know where else to look. I think of John Paul II, and I think of his witness, and I think of the courage that he had amidst uncertainty. He had this smile that was so confident in God amidst all of the darkness that the world could throw at him. My brothers and sisters, the world is not going to change unless we start living in courage, rooted in love. And it's only by doing so will we begin to be the gifts that we were meant to be. It's hard, it's difficult, the world is a trying place. But as Pope John Paul II famously said, "Be not afraid."Yo, thanks for checking out that video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to The Culture Project. Hit that notification bell if you want to stay up to date with all our videos. And see you guys next week. Peace. Oh, and pray for me. It's really cold and really windy, which, I mean, maybe I should adjust warmer. Who knows? All right, peace. Later. Oh, it's so bright. Ah!